What is an environmental aspect? This is an element of the organization's activities, products, or services that interacts with or may interact with the environment, so they may have impact on the environment. What is an environmental impact? This is a change in the environment, both adverse and beneficial, which as a whole or partly results from the environmental performance of the organization. In accordance with the main assumptions of the environmental management standard, the aim of identifying and assessing environmental aspects will be to improve the relationship between the environment and the effects of the organization's performance. The identification of environmental aspects in due manner will allow us to carry out a comprehensive assessment of the environmental impact. The ISO 14001 standard obliges us to establish a process for identifying the environmental aspects of an organization that have or may have an impact on the environment and that may be affected by that organization. So, what should we do? Simply speaking, you have to review the legal requirements with regard to the environment and analyze all conditions of typical and non-typical activities of the organization. For example, at production startup, potentially dangerous conditions, failures. You have to do this to assess the organization's environmental impact, such as emissions to water, air, soil, consumption of raw materials, and natural resources. That is to say, you will define the changes in the environment, both adverse and beneficial, resulting from the environmental aspects of the organization. And at all times, considering the life cycle of the product. The concept of life cycle of the product has just appeared. As it was mentioned in the previous lesson, while implementing the environmental management system, we can't think about what is here and now. We must focus on our products and services in a comprehensive way. This means that we should analyze the environmental impact of our products and services in every phase of their life cycle. This is what life cycle assessment is for. Life cycle assessment, LCA, is a methodology for assessing environmental impacts that analyzes environmental risks throughout the product lifecycle. Thanks to this, no aspect of the manufacture, functioning, and disposal of the product is overlooked. In the LCA, all ecosystems and their components are taken into consideration. Furthermore, the LCA identifies the full environmental impact of the product. A properly conducted LCA helps us make decisions and helps to indicate the product or process that will have the least environmental impact. Okay, that would be all in terms of theory. Now, let's move on to practice. At this moment, I will tell you how to put this complex theory into practice. We will move on to the identification of environmental aspects. While identifying environmental aspects, it will be helpful to map activities, processes carried out within the organization and assign environmental aspects to them by means of the input and output method. So, you will list all the input and output data related to materials, raw materials, or energy. Product-related aspects will, on the other hand, relate to the environmental impacts associated with the production of raw materials and intermediate products or impacts associated with use and disposal after the use phase. On this basis, it will also be easy for you to determine the environmental impact. Let's assume that you run a transportation company. Your business activities are, among others, order processing, loading and unloading, and transport, of course. You also have an office where you manage your transport orders, and you do not sit in this office in the dark. Let's take operation of lighting into consideration. The input data will certainly be electricity, as well as the fluorescent lamps, and the output data will be waste in the form of used fluorescent lamps and packaging waste. The environmental aspect will be the generation of the aforementioned waste, as well as electricity consumption. Let's take a closer look at the process of order processing. The input data for the order processing will be information sent by the customer, that is, electronic orders. So our company needs electricity and computer equipment to operate properly. In this case, the output data will be a transport order. that is, a printed sheet of paper. It seems that our environmental aspects will be, on the one hand, the use of natural resources, coal to produce electricity, but also trees to produce paper, and on the other hand, waste generation, printer toners, waste electrical equipment, waste paper. And what will be the associated environmental impacts? The greenhouse effect, air quality deterioration, burdening the environment with waste. Is it quite clear? Turn on the pause and try now to write down the environmental aspects and related impacts for loading and unloading activities on your own. Remember that the suggested input and output method is not obligatory. It should be perceived as a best practice for identifying environmental aspects and related impacts, which will ensure that we analyse our organisation's activities in a comprehensive and complete manner in terms of its relationship with the environment.